What's up, everybody? We've made it to Pigeon Forge for the rod run. We're at our cabin now. Figured I'd give y'all guys a quick little tour. As you can see here behind me, that's the common area, pool house and all that, little picnic area. Actually, back behind it, over there this way, there's actually a waterfall. You can actually see it more in the winter and after, of course, heavy rains. Let me flip this. We normally stay in one of these couple little cabins over here. The first one over there is a single room. That's a two bedroom next to it. There's another single room over there. There's several of them. Here's the one we're staying in. It's actually a little bigger than the one we normally stay at, same price. They're remodeling the one up the hill up there. But every one of these cabins have a little creek that runs behind it. Same thing over here. You got a creek that runs behind this, and then the creeks merge and run out over here. Creek on that side over there behind these is a little bit better in my opinion. Anyway, this is cabin number 5. So let's give y'all a quick little walkthrough tour. Mrs. has done made herself at home. She says hey. Nice little living room, good furniture. It's got a little table here. Full kitchen, fully stocked. Washer and dryer. So this is a two bedroom cabin. So you can see, nice little rustic cabin. This one here's got a bit of a small bathroom. But the master, on the other hand, is a bit bigger. Bigger for the master. And a bigger bathroom. Nice little cabin. Then out here on the back porch, completely screened in back porch. There you see, we got a little creek running behind us. And a hot tub. We'll be putting this thing to use later. So it's kind of nice. Only downside of the cabin number 5 is you do have another cabin right here behind us. Other than that, all these other cabins, your back porches are actually private. Usually has a privacy wall on each end if you're next to another cabin so you can't see. That's the only downside of this particular cabin. Anyway, tonight we're just going to chill and hang out here at the cabin and relax, and then we'll go out on the strip tomorrow, check out some cars, and have a little fun. All right, stay tuned.
Now this is how you start your morning off. Drinking coffee, sitting there listening to a little creek run by. This is a very peaceful morning. I really need a house by a creek. I'd be doing this every morning. enjoying her coffee right now. Well, still gotta get the missus up. But I'm gonna drink coffee and get ready, and then we're gonna head on out to the strip and start checking out some of these cool rides. I think we're gonna go to the actual show first. The Grand Run, the Grand Rod Run is what this used to be called. Now everybody just calls it the Rod Run. used to, the show was like, so-so. Because everybody parks up and down the strip and Pigeon Forge, and the show used to be something, let me tell you. Back in the day, hell, the city would set up bleachers on the side of the road. And that way you could just, people would park their cars, they'd sit the bleachers, set up lawn chairs. And all the old cars would get on the strip at night and cruise. Now, unfortunately, almost all the old cars stay parked, most of them. And bunch of four-wheel drives and diesels and all that out there on the strip. So the show isn't what it used to be. Like I said, though, it's still a good show. There's still a ton of cars there, and the actual main show has seemed like it's gotten better and bigger from what I've heard. So first time I've actually went to the main official show you pay to get in years. First, usually, I said, you come up here, and you don't go to the show. You just go up and down the strip. Hot tub kicked them. You just will go up and down the strip. You can spend all day going from one side down the other if you're walking it, because it's miles, and still not see everything. So there's a lot of cars here. Matter of fact, I think at one point this was considered the largest cruise in North America. I don't know if it still is, but it's big as far as cars showing up for technically not an official show, because you know they don't go over to the official show; they just park on the strip. Anyways, I'm going to finish drinking my coffee. Sit here and listen to this creek a little bit more. Hopefully this hot tub shuts off. I ain't going to listen to it hum. Go prod the old lady. See if I can get her out of bed. And we'll get this rest of this video started. So stay tuned and we'll see y'all here. Well, for y'all it'll be a second, but y'all get what I'm saying. Here, just stay tuned. Walking up on the show. I'm recording, just kind of getting a top side view. So, yeah. All right. Officially in the rod run. There's this decorative signs and stuff. I like the tailgate. That's cool. Oh, I'm just looking at the signs here, babe. Speedmaster booth. About to check out this, like a Dukes of Hazzard museum and a couple of General Lees. Two of the generals. That's an awesome trailer. I lost my wife. Oh, there she is. Seen clothes. She got distracted. Cool look for some wheels. I like that artillery. Yeah, just pop, no matter. All your event shirts. Oh, rock it up next to Rocky by far. That's why all the folks on Rocky Top get their corn from the jar. Rocky Top, you always be home sweet home to me. Girl, Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Thank you.
indoor part of the show. Let's see.
What was it saying?
Just let me know that the mic is connected. All of her signs and stuff. A little bit of everything. Yeah. Oh, Willis. 41 Willis. Cat right there. I'm getting around to it. There's an actual flathead. It's pretty. Got a little, oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me, sir. Good, you?
Good.
Sorry. Rock clips for about anything you're building. People buy these to keep the really nice cars in, to keep them clean and dry. Nope, threw it away.
Probably.
What is it, climate? Yeah, climate, moisture, everything.
You can live in it.
Yep. Oh, I think it's clothing or something. Here's your drink. Yeah, proud blue collar. I like that. Thank you. Campbell. You're fine.
It's all good. I'm just going to get out of the way.
Good looking Ford truck here. Pretty. Not a Chevy guy, but that is good looking C10. Clean, just clean. Box body. River Shelby. Tri-5. Chevelle. Oh, it was cool. Actual custom. Cotton candy. I bet that started life as a Mercury. Yep. Excuse me.
No, I'm not lecturing you. Just a couple's
block. Oh, look at there. Still got the Y block in it. 55 or 56 Mercury. There's a good view. You're fine. Now this is gorgeous. 34 Ford. Real dark green. Ah, what a heavy chop. Man, that thing is gorgeous.
No,
all alone. Got burned out there. Like I said, I'm just
wondering. There are more vendors here than there are cars. Too crowded in here.
I can't wait for tomorrow. I'm not biased. I have one.
I like that color.
Yeah, I like that gray. I said, I'm not a green fan, but I like the color of this one. Too crowded in here to really get a video. An old Viper, yeah. God damn it, quit locking them. Over there. It's a complete customs. Good lord at that motor. Supercharger and turbos.
Nitrous in the trunk.
Huh?
Nitrous bottles in the trunk.
Got all the goodies. Hit it one time, they're going to blow through the roof.
Oh, I love it.
Pretty wood. Yep.
I want one.
You want one?
I grew up.
I like this little truck.
I can paint it that color.
Show you my favorite one. It's over here. I already videoed it once, but I'll do it again. National. You're fine.
No, it does.
Camaro with the flames or the Firebird?
I don't know. I like both of them.
Of course, you can't really see it on camera because all the people. You're good. Go ahead, buddy. Needing. Pat's Blue Ribbon. You're good.
I'm That's my only danger, though.
Somebody took an airplane and made a car out of it.
Got a barcode on the side of it.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Moving Ford truck.
Whatever that is, that's crazy.
I like that. The little one.
Traditional hot rod.
Yep.
That's pretty sharp. Nice little roadster there. Sorry. That's cool. I like that. There you go, baby. Here's your Trans Am. Your Tesla will never be this cool. That's awesome. Oh, he's got some airbrush art on it. Very nice. Man, look at
like that.
Yeah.
Approachable than I am, honey. Don't you say I always look like a grumpy asshole?
Are you doing audio?
Yeah, it's audio, but I can still record over there. Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was embroidered.
No, but I like the lettering. There's a style truck you're actually wanting. The hood up, just. Good looking Ford truck there. Look at that beast.
I see something like that for Jackson. I don't know. I just see a big old vehicle. I don't know.
I like it. Yep. Sad. This show is mainly vendors here, so. Yeah, the strips were all the cars. All right, back in the car. Like I said, that show, the actual show itself around here is not that good. It's mainly just vendors. There's probably was 30 cars inside and a few more outside. The main thing is the strip. Like I said, the strip's miles long. We'll be doing some cruising through the parking lot and you'll get to see a ton of cars that way. So the actual show, you pay $20 to get in for a person, and if you're looking for parts and stuff, it's fine. It's all new vendors, not a swap meet. But yeah, it is what it is. So the best part of this is, like I said, the actual strip, which we're gonna go get some lunch, then we'll head out onto it.
And you don't have to walk.
Yeah, and you don't have to walk. You can do like we do. We kind of cruise through the parking lots. Of course, you can have your golf cart up here, your little electric cart, whatever. Or you can walk it. I have literally parked at one end, walked all the way down and all the way back up, and it will take you all day and you'll be wore out, but you can do it. So anyway, let's go get some food and we'll go check out some more stuff. Cool milk truck here. We got painted up with a Dairy Queen logo. I am just trying to.
Mustang.
sevens. Your shoebox, boss. Number 51. Lampoon's wagon there. Good looking 55 crown bit, I think. Couple cars I seen last night when we were riding around. I see them, hoping the owners would have something talking about.
great.
Second, a guy in the red shirt with up on his arms. For a second, it looked kind of like Jeremy. Kind of, what the fuck?
Well, there's I was just letting you know that we're driving in the parking lot.
Have you seen the cops?
Yeah. So you're drifting.
Love the paint job.
Thanks, man.
brown Trans Am.
Pick of the whole show, Ford Pinto.
Bobby's had an egg. I think it eggs trapped in here.
Thank you.
All right, everybody, we are back from the rod run. Walking out of the garage, figured I'd show you. Hold on 1 second. Anyway, like I said, we're back from the rod run. Bought a few things from the vendors, nothing major. Figured I'd show you what all we bought here, so let me flip the camera. Starting off, these are just good to have in case of emergency. It was $10. One of the little cheap electric fuel pumps. Got some of the spark plug sleeves. I think I paid $20 for the heat shield. Since our driver's side, I ain't gonna use all these, just the ones that are real close, just to help protect them. Got this little probe tester, but it actually will tell you the volts. It'll give you a reading as you're testing it, letting you know how much current's going through it up to, I can't remember what it said. Anyway, let me see here. Let's just dump this out, it'll be easier. Da, 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 da. Couple headlight pigtails. We're gonna need those soon. There's two taillight pigtails. These seem to be better quality than the ones I got. I bought some from AutoZone or Advance, and the springs on it is very weak and didn't want to lock in. Anyway, it's got two weatherproof push buttons for our solenoids for our door poppers. There's a distribution block. That way I can run power to it and split back out. Then we got a toggle switch. Nothing special, but that's probably for our fuel pump. And we got another little bag over here. A little magazine, event magazine. I ain't even flipped through the thing yet. A free koozie. Little power port. We'll put that in the car somewheres. Another distribution block. Decide which one of those I want to use. Just one of them's got a few extra spots. Other than that, it's just some cards and all. So, didn't buy a whole lot. Just some little things we'll be needing soon. Finishing up the wiring on the car. Like I said, right now, I've got a few different things coming right off of one, right off the main power terminal. So, this way we can divide it, whether we do it here or there or whatever. Now, about the show. Show is okay. The grand run, like I said earlier in the video, it's just not what it used to be. Show used to be great. I mean, it used to be a great time, burnout contest, and, you know, but it's, I don't know, I think the show's kind of dying overall. There was also the Smoky Mountain Truck Fest this same weekend, which also explains why there's so many trucks in this video. You'll see we passed by a lot of new ones. But there was a ton of C10s, and I don't know. It's not my kind of show anymore. It used to be a lot better back in the day. I don't think I'm probably going to go to it in the future. I'm probably going to go to it one more time, just because I've always wanted to be able to drive one of my own cars. So once the 51 is, you know, done and on the road, I'll take it up there at least once, probably for a day, and then come home. I ain't going to stay the weekend or nothing. Just to say I've finally taken the car to the rod run, because it's always been one of those things I wanted to do. Other than that, I'd rather go like the Redneck Rumble or drive all the way to Lone Star Roundup. I just think they're better shows. And some of the smaller shows are actually funner, and I'd rather go to a driving event. So anyway, like I said, the show was okay. The actual official show, the one where you pay to get in, it was more vendors than anything. What's funny is back in the day, it was always been a smaller show, but it used to. There'd still be 150, 200 cars at the show, and then there wasn't that many vendors. Now there wasn't that many actual cars, and there was a ton of vendors. So it's changed a lot. Like I said, though, I think that's about it. This ain't going to be, you know, I know this ain't the most exciting video. Just stringing a whole lot of these clips together. That way y'all can see what it was. Like I said, I wish y'all could have seen this show back in the day. God, it used to be just a ball, you know, 20 years ago and all that. But it's been taken over by the four-wheel drive diesel crowd and yada, yada, yada. There's still old cars up there, and there's some cool old cars you'll see in the picture. There was a few cars I really wanted to stop and talk to the people that owned them. And, like, there were some cars when we drove up Friday, I seen them. And I spent the rest of the time we were out and about trying to find these cars again. Unfortunately, we were dropping little man off with his, we were dropping him off with his stepdad and all that, his actual dad. And I'm the stepdad. But anyways, we were dropping him off, and then so we had to meet them, and I never could find these cars after that. There was this really cool custom 53-4 Chevy chopped and everything. Would love to talk to that guy. But there's a couple of other ones. I just seen there was a few cool customs, but most of it was just mainly muscle cars, tri-fives, and C-10s and square bodies. Oh, good Lord, out the square bodies and the C-10s. And I said, I'm a Ford guy, so it didn't really appeal to me that much. I don't know. I respect them. There was some clean, clean C-10s, of which I'm sure y'all seen on the video. Anyway, but we'll attend better shows, and I'll do better footage. It's just so crowded up there, and I didn't feel like parking. It was also mine and wife's anniversary, and we didn't want to spend it just walking the strip. We wanted time together, so that's why we done the parking lot cruise. We just cruise through the parking lots, get out, and dip in another parking lot. Easiest way to do that. But we got other shows coming up. Ones where I'll actually be out and about walking, talking, interviewing people, talking about their cars. We'll do specific cars. But that's it for this video, man. I hope y'all liked it. You know, like, subscribe, comment, come back for future content. We're getting back to work on the 51. We're going to try to get this front end finish up. Get some more body work done on it. And we're about to start work on the 58 F800, the car hauler project. Got the part in to fix my compressor, so we're going to get that fixed. We're about to pull up this secondary 58 cab I have and cut it up. I said, y'all seen I've just recently pressure washed this thing, got it all cleaned up, got the firewall cleaned up. You know, I've been scraping off the undercoat that was all on. I ain't got it all off, like there's still some on this side here. But we're getting rid of all that. And hopefully getting ready to go pick up a chassis soon if I can get with the guy. Hopefully he's still got it by the time I'm able to go get it. Anyways, we're getting ready to pull that up here where we can start hacking it up. So we're gonna cut the front end of it off. We're gonna cut it off the back because I think I've decided I'm just going to use the back of that cab. This one here is just, it's pretty beat up. I mean, that one there's got some dings and dang, whiskey dents and all that in it, but it needs cab corners, but it's not as bad as this one. And come on, flip. Like I say, I pressure wash the floor in here. There's spots of this which are starting to get a little thin. I've got to decide, like here, we do have Russo here. I know we're going to be replacing the steps, that panel there. We're going to do the lower front door post and, of course, you know, lower cab corners. But I'm trying to decide how much of this floor. Most of this floor is pretty solid. I need to check on what all patch panels are available. I know these are and these are. And I think they make some of the floor. I don't know what all they make. So we gotta start getting our panels in. Like this area here is rotten on this door. I'm not able to get the passenger door open, but the driver's side is good on that other truck and it's starting to rot out. So we're probably gonna, if it's good in that other truck, we're gonna cut it out, patch it over. So that other truck, the floors and stuff are worse than this one, as you can see here. So this one here is actually not terrible. I think I can get away with just replacing the step on this side. Other than that, the floors are decently solid, except for starting to get some rot in here. But we might be able to just patch a little bit of that. But it's a lot cleaner than it was. make it easier to work. Hell, even the doorpost here has got some damage in it. We'll have to straighten out. But when it comes to swapping these out, we're just going to do the actual spot welds along the side. So of course, the other one, I'm just going to go in and cut it. So, but this one here, we'll take off spot welds and we'll strip that one on the bench. But that's coming up in future videos. Anyway, I appreciate y'all watching. Like I said, like, subscribe, comment, and tune in for future episodes. Until then, man, y'all keep it real.